fighting to take Hadida from Iran-backed militias.
Lucy, what are you doing? What are you doing, Lucy? Could worsen an already critical situation. What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Go and get it then. Go on. Go and get it. And those on it. It is. Sir, pee box. How to reduce the risk of dementia. It will be included as part of the NHS health check after a successful pilot, James Shippen reports.
Almost 7 million people in England have had what's known as an NHS health check during the past 5 years. It's offered to people between the ages of 40 and 74, and until now has focused on reducing premature deaths from cardiovascular disease. But in future, part of the test will see GPs and other healthcare professionals advising patients on how to reduce the risk of developing dementia. They'll say that lifestyle choices, such as eating a healthy diet, not smoking, and keeping active, can help prevent dementia as well as cardiovascular problems. They'll tell patients that what's good for the heart is good for the brain. Public Health England estimates that over 850,000 people in the UK are living with dementia. It says that as many as one third of cases could be prevented by living a healthier lifestyle. James Shippen, BBC News.
You do it again, she said.
It's the fans who are hit the hardest. Now a Scottish arts and music festival is piloting new technology in an attempt to halt the professional fraudsters. Fringe by the Sea in North Berwick has teamed
I'm going to get in this cat and move you going like you or not. It's
no longer a piece of paper that can easily change hands, Katrina Renton reports.
Ed Sheeran at this year's biggest weekend. One of the latest artists to declare war against touts. On his latest tour, he targeted some secondary sites. Ticket touts make a profit by selling them at vastly inflated prices. In some cases, up to 8 times the original value.
Pop concerts and big events are often targeted by ticket touts. They snap them up as soon as they go on sale and then resell them at sky-high prices, meaning fans sometimes end up paying far more than the face value.
No one we spoke to waiting to see Demi Lovato in Glasgow had paid over the odds, but some have been caught out in the past.
In Cork in Ireland, yeah, I paid like, I think it was €100 each for 2 tickets.
You're a cheeky dog. What are you?
It's not fair to charge like
extra. Cheeky dog. If you pay a certain
$100 and something for tickets from
a bus seat for my daughter and her pals. So yeah, I get well pleased. Fringe by the Sea is a growing arts and music festival in North Berwick. Man, you gave me
your tickets.
I like the way she does that with her back legs.
Fringe by the Sea is a very small festival with small intimate venues with a maximum capacity of 600. So what we see is that kids can sell out ludicrously quick time on some of the bigger artists. Last year we had Katie Dunstall, who sold out within 2 minutes. And where those tickets went, we're not entirely sure. We're not able to track as efficiently as we are with the new system.
These are the performers of the future. It's hoped the technology the company working with
Strange the dog.
Is using will protect them.
Basically, what we do is we use identity profiling each person to make sure they're not pitched out or someone's dodgy.
What are you doing?
We then link all that to a wallet rather than a ticket. So you're handing over your whole identity and wallet form rather than just an individual ticket that can kind of go the next day. And then we link all that to a blockchain. So it's on an open ledger and transparent for everyone to see.
This is the biggest test for this new system to date. If it works here, the company says the sky's the limit for the scale of events they can work with.
No, she's got a nose in it now. Did
now it's time for an update on the weather with Phil Avery.
Hello once again. Let's see how the rest of the weekend is going to pan out across the British Isles. It started none too cheerily across a good part of Scotland, Northern Ireland, some of the western fringes of England and Wales too, because we've got a weather front close by. Into the evening, I think some of the heaviest of downpours are also migrating into the eastern side of Scotland, the northeast of England, before moving off into the North Sea. Following on behind, clear skies allowing the temperatures to dribble away to single figures.
You show off. You sure are. The big show off, aren't you?
Which just thickens up all the while. After a dry enough start across Wales and the southwest, I think there'll be some
rain
into the afternoon. So too into Northern Ireland, eventually towards the northwest of England, maybe into the southwest of Scotland. If you haven't had a mention thus far, you're probably going to get away with a bulk of a dry day. Top temperature around about 19, possibly a 20 somewhere. On into the start of next week, we keep it pretty unsettled across northern parts, but it certainly will warm up in the south.
Live from Russia, Sports Day will bring you the World Cup from every angle. We'll have the latest news and action from on and off the pitch. That's World Cup Sports
what you
Day
doing?
Tonight at 6:30.
What you doing? What you doing? What you doing? I know what you're doing. Oh, she's going back to her box. No, she isn't. Where's your box? Go blow your box. Go on. Blow your box. No. Why? What's up with your box? Look, it's all alone. Your box. Your box. It's all alone. Yeah. No, you're enough, have you? Yeah, you're enough. You're enough, huh? All right, then. See you later. See you later. Go on, then. Go on, then. Get out. That's it.